This man, an Afghanistan native who served as an interpreter for the U.S. military, has been seeking asylum here in Iowa for the past 6 years. He even was promised some help from Iowa Senator Chuck Grassley to move this process along, but this week, asylum was denied. This was a major blow to Zalmay Niazy, who believes his life is in danger if he returns to Afghanistan. Mr. Niazy joins us now with his attorney, Keith Herding, checking in here in just a minute as well. Zalmay, let's talk about the key sticking point here. The U.S. Board of Immigration Appeals says that when you were 9 years old, a member of the Taliban grabbed you and told you to bring them a piece of bread or he was going to burn your house down. You got the man some bread, fearing for your life, and according to that government body, that now constitutes giving aid to a foreign terrorist organization. Have I summed that up correctly?
Yes, sir, that's correct. And as the whole world has witnessed that today, the Taliban power and their crucial politics and their extremist policies and way of treating human being in Afghanistan or around where they are operating is totally unethical and un-Islamical or whatever you call it.
Zalmay, I'm curious though, so that's what you're accused of doing when you were a 9-year-old boy. Please explain to our viewers what you did when you were a grown man to help our American troops who were in your country.
Yes, sir. I had an interview today too that it was always my honor and my pleasure that I have to return the favor that has been done to us. I was a very little kid when I was going to school. Every day we were seeing difference in our lives, in our school system, in our education system and everything. And when we were asking our teachers as a very teenagers that they were saying that American people are here that to help us build a school and build us mosques, bridges, and bring a difference in our life. So that was my pleasure always. I was telling my family that how will I be able to tell them thank you to those soldiers that they were handing us these gifts and these supplies and stuff, and they were working hard for us. And she said that when you grow up, you will be a man and you will help to serve your country and the people that came and served.
And that's what you did as an
interpreter. And that's what I did. And graduating high school, everybody chose to go to college, chose to go to university. And I was a very smart kid, got graduated with the first position from my class. And I said, it's time for me to join and I have to do what it takes to make this process more easy, and we will have more stability and peace and love in our country while they're here.
It's got to be a really long story, and we're running out of time, but I want you to quickly tell people how you ended up in Iowa Falls, Iowa.
First I lived in Washington, D.C. I have a cousin that he lives with me. We both live together, and he was here, and he said it's a very easy life. Iowa is a great country. People are very, very, very good. And life is economical too. We will start our new life here in Iowa. And I moved to Iowa Falls. It was a cultural, it was a shock, but I love it. And I'm very overwhelmed with the support of my community.
Yeah, you even have your, we can see the logo on your shirt. You've started a handyman service there in Iowa Falls. We know how much that community has rallied around you because they've reached out to us trying to get us to share your story. Zalmay's attorney, Keith Herding from here in Des Moines, is joining us as well now. Please explain to us what Senator Grassley, Keith, if you can chime in, explain what involvement Senator Grassley has or hasn't had in this case.
Well, a few years back, Zalmay did ask him a question at town hall that basically boiled down to who's going to look out for him, that Zalmay had put his life in danger on multiple occasions, survived multiple assassination attempts because he was working with U.S. forces, that he was providing support to American servicemen and women, and that he's now here. He was able to survive those assassination attempts. He lost an uncle as a result of his work, that he was killed by the Taliban. And So he asked Chuck Grassley, who is going to look out for me? And Chuck Grassley said, well, I'll help. And, you know, it helped that he was in front of some cameras while saying that. Since then, we've gotten one or two emails from him saying, hey, we don't know what's going on with the case, or we have an update, or we don't have an update. But he hasn't, beyond those emails, I haven't had a contact with his staff in years.
Keith, any more appeals, or have they all been exhausted? What's the situation? Does he have another chance?
No, there are still procedures left for Zalmay. He is not, being removed at this moment. He still has steps that he has available to him. But the finding that he had supported terrorism is going to be a difficult one for him to overcome.
Let's take a look quickly, Keith, at the statement from Senator Grassley. I don't mean to cut you off, but in fairness, I do want to get this statement on. Ultimately, the federal agency in this case, USCIS, is responsible for making final determinations based on the facts of the case and the law. Lawmakers don't have a legal role to play in adjudicating or influencing those agency decisions. I mean, there's definitely some truth to that, correct? He says it's important to note there are a number of further steps and appeals available to Mr. Niazy before any determination is final. But do you take this as the senator saying he's done all he can? There's no more lawmaker intervention that's going to happen here.
Well, what he's saying is that the process of the laws has resulted with Zalmay in this position. And he acknowledges he's a lawmaker. I guess if he understands that Zalmay has been put in this situation because of the laws, and he is a lawmaker, it looks like he has an opportunity to address that by correcting the laws, by making a system that does find a place for Zalmay to find safety here in the country that he has supported.
Zalmay, last question for you. What do you truly think will happen to you if you return to Afghanistan?
When I came to the United States, I got stamped on my forehead that before I was just an interpreter, now I am a U.S. spy, and I will be returning back from United States to be a U.S. spy, and I will even destroy the terrorists even more. And now I've been accused by the United States government that to support terrorists, and I don't know what else to do. I'd rather hung and destroyed here in the United States than sending me back home, because that is a crucial death. I'd rather be died. If I support a terrorist at the age of 9, if they condemn me of that, then I have to be destroyed. But I don't have any way. I am in danger of my life. I've been struggling the last 4, 5, 6 years that I'm in the United States, and my family went through so many different things. And unfortunately, this week has been very terrible and hard for me too, that I just found out from my family that said that my best friend that was in news and we were interpreter together, he got killed in Kandahar, which is not far away from where I have born and raised. And that was even heartbreaking for me too.
I'm so sorry for your loss. Zalmay Niazy of Iowa Falls by way of Afghanistan. Thanks for being on the program. And we are definitely going to keep all of you at home up to date as he continues this process of trying to stay in America.
Thank you very much for your time.